Hello, good morning, everyone. So we will continue the torque analysis of a single plate clutch. So as you know, the derivation for axial force as well as the frictional torque, you got two equations. That is what axial force Fa can be obtained by the equation pi p divided by 4 into dO square minus di square. Okay. And similarly, you got a torque, you can calculate using the relation for uniform pressure theory. Is 1/2 F into Fa into dm. So here Fa is the axial force, dm is what? It is a mean diameter. Okay. It's what mean diameter? Okay. Fa is the axial force. Now today we'll continue the uniform wear theory. This is what uniform wear theory. So now this theory is applicable for Wernher clutches, which are based on the assumption that the wear is uniformly distributed over the entire surface area of the disc. Okay. So let us consider an partial portion of a clutch plate here. Now, if you treat it as a normal, that is what uniform pressure. So you are going to get a worn out of the clutch plate more at outer surface and less at inner surface. If you want to maintain this uniform wear, that means if you want to maintain the uniform wear throughout its radial distance. Now the distribution of pressure should be here. It is in a variation here. Okay. It is what? Variation. Okay. So now P is what? Pressure intensity. So yeah, it goes on varying from inner diameter to the outer diameter. Okay. So now the work of friction. Now the work of friction is proportional to the product of pressure and sliding velocity. Okay, so if you take a small segment of the clutch here, okay, now you're going to get an angular speed. Okay, now the wear is an property, you can say is going to burn out the surfaces as the friction is goes on applying over the one plate over the another plate. Okay, now you can say wear is what? It is proportional to the pressure intensity as well as its angular velocity or angular speed. Okay. If you consider V as a velocity, then this wear is proportional to the P into omega into R here. So omega into R. Suppose if you consider the speed as a constant, then wear it is what? It proportional to the pressure intensity and the radial distance. That is what R. So if you consider R here, you have some wear. If you consider a more radial distance, here, you are going to get a more worn out surface and less worn out surface here. Let us assume if wear has to be uniform, then we'll consider a constant here for calculation purpose. Now, if the wear is to uniform, okay, then the product of the pressure and radial distance are to be some constant here. Are to be constant. Now, what will you get a pressure intensity? If you consider a constant as C, now the pressure intensity is what? P equal to C by R. P equal to C by R. Now, if you consider the axial force, if you consider the axial force, what I got axial force? Fa equal to integration from Ri to R naught. Okay. It is what 2 pi R. 2 pi r into p into dr. Now let us substitute. We'll take a constant term outside here. 2 pi is a constant term. Okay, so we'll replace the value of p into r into dr as a c here. Okay. It is not a constant. What will get axial force equation? 2 pi r into c into r, okay, from the limit ri to r naught. Now you substitute 2 pi C D naught minus DI all divided by 2. What will get? 2 pi C divided by 2. It is what? D naught minus DI. Now we'll substitute value of constant. Value of constant. Now what will get a, okay, let us substitute again in terms of R naught R I here to get the value of constant C. As you got the equation for pressure in uniform pressure theory. Now let us substitute. We'll go back the earlier equation. What are the equation we're going to get here? Axial force Fa equal to 2 pi C R naught minus Ri. Okay. R naught minus Ri. So based on this equation. Okay. Now let us substitute. Now we can calculate C, it is what? Fa divided by, okay, Fa divided by 2 pi R naught minus Ri. R naught minus Ri. Now let us consider the frictional torque now based on this uniform wear theory. Uniform wear theory. So already I noted an equation, that is what torque T can be calculated as 2 pi F into P R square into dr ri to r naught. Okay. Let us further simplify this equation. I'll rewrite here T into 2 pi R into F R into P Ri to R naught into dr. Now what this equation yields? This equation yields 2 pi F into C R into dr Ri to R naught. Now if you integrate the above equation in the limits Ri to R naught, okay, what will get?